Hello everyone, welcome to day 9th of November Lead Code Challenge, and let's quickly walk through today's question. Today's question is number of valid words for each puzzle. In this question, we are given two arrays. One is the puzzle array, other one is a word array, and we are given some rules whether a particular word is a valid word with respect to a puzzle. We need to return an answer array that tells us the number of words from the given list that is valid with respect to the ith puzzle in the puzzle list. We need to return that answer array. Now let's talk about how can we say that a particular word abides to a particular puzzle. The word contains the first character of the puzzle. This is the foremost thing. The other thing is, for each letter in the word, the letter should be in the puzzle. For example, let's assume the puzzle is A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, and the valid words are FACED, cabbage and baggage. Why can we say this? Because all the characters that are present in the word are also present in the puzzle for all these three strings, cabbage, baggage and phased. Number of valid words for each puzzle, lead code 1178. It's a hard level question on lead code and I also feel the same. Even before going into the detailed analysis, let's try to reduce the problem into smaller sub-problems. Let's try to think of from an interviewee's perspective, what will he think when he reads this question. So let's take a very simple case. We have reduced the puzzle to a singular one and there are only two words that are given to us. The first word is ACCAA and the second one is AEDDDCC. The puzzle is ABCD. Let's try and check whether these two words fall into this puzzle or not. The first word is ACCAA. It starts with the character A and it has the first character that is present in the puzzle. So we are good. The first condition is met. The second condition is all the letters that exist in the word should be part of the puzzle. There are only two types of characters, A and C, and puzzle also contains AC in it. That means the word lies and is valid as per this puzzle. Let's talk about the next case. We have A, E, D and C. These are the four letters that exist in the word. Does all of them part of the puzzle? No, E is not part of the puzzle. So this is an invalid entry. Now, how can you build the algorithm? The first thing that comes to everybody's mind is to create set of characters that exist in the puzzle. And then we create the set of characters that exist in the word. For each word, we will create a set of characters that are present in this word. So again, a set of characters, and this corresponds to this particular word. We'll create another set of characters that corresponds to this particular word. Now we will do the comparison between these two sets. If all the elements that are present in this particular set are also present in this particular set, then we can say that this particular word can be generated and is valid as per this puzzle. If the condition is not met, if this particular set is not a subset of the puzzle character set, then we say it's an invalid entry and that particular word is not valid as per the puzzle. The time complexity for this comparison would be equal to order of length of characters that exist in each word. And every time you'll have to compare it with the set of the puzzle that you have generated. The overall complexity will become quite high because it's in the question we are not given a singular puzzle, rather we are giving multiple puzzles. It's an array of puzzles. Then how can we improvise this solution? Let's reduce this problem of iterating over the set again and again to something simpler. And what is that thing? We will use bit masking. So we are aware that there are only 26 characters in English lowercase dictionary. So what do we do? Whatever characters are present in each word, we'll create a mask for it. We'll enable that particular bit in the integer range. For example, we have A in the first word and the next character that we have is C. So we will go and update the 0th index to 1 and the Cth index, which would be 3. So 0 corresponds to A, B corresponds to 1, and the third character would be C, which corresponds to second index. and so on. So we will toggle this particular entry as 1 instead of 0, and we generated a bit mask kind of a thing where rest of the characters will be 0 because they are not present in this particular word. As a result of which, their entries would be 0 in the bit mask. We'll exactly do the same thing for ABCD as well. So let's generate the mask for ABCD. So we have A here, A gets enabled. We have B here, B gets enabled. We have C here, C gets enabled. We have D here, D gets enabled. The rest of the entries would be 0. This is for ABCD, and this particular bit mask is for ACCAA. Now we need to check whether this particular bit mask is a subset of this particular bit mask. How do we do that? We will AND these two up. Let's try and perform the AND operation. Let me just change the color of pen. And when we perform the AND operation between these two, what do we get? We get 0 here and we get 0 here. We get 0 here again because this is 0, this is 1. We get 1 here. We get 0 here and we get 1 here again. We can see that the generated integer number is exactly same as the word bit mask that we created. We had ones at two places, second index and zeroth index. Similarly, in the output mask that we generated, one is activated only at two places, second and the zeroth index, by virtue of this AND operation. We have reduced the complexity from order of length of the set of characters that we had in each word to a singular AND operation, and this can be generated, the output bit mask can be generated in order of one time. Here we get an edge over the regular approach that we thought of. Can we do something further to improvise this logic? The answer is yes. Let's see how. Let's consider the case to the actual problem that was specified in the question. We have multiple puzzles given to us, and we need to validate against each word that is given to us. So, do we need to do it for every possible word that exists in the words array? No. Can we do something to improvise this? The answer is yes. So, what I'm gonna do, I'll create an array list, basically a map that states all the words containing each character in the input words. Let's try and understand it. Let's create a map of character, comma, list of strings or list of bit mask. We have A, we have B, we have C, we have D, we have E, we have F, and so on. So let's go and iterate over all the words that we have. We can see that A exists in all the four words, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So A will be pa A is present in A C C A A E D C C B A G, and the last one is B A. Let's move ahead, and against the second index, what we will store all the words containing B. So there are two words containing B, B A G and B A. Let's move ahead. Then we have C. So we have two words containing C, and A C C A A, comma A E D. C C. Let's proceed ahead. Next we have D, and there is only one word containing D. A E D D C C. And for the rest of the strings, you can proceed ahead in the similar fashion. How this is helping us in reducing your time complexity? So let's try and understand that. We see the first puzzle that is given to us is ABCD. So what is the first character of ABCD? The first character of ABCD is A. So which list do we need to actually check? We are only interested in these many characters that exist against A. Rest of the characters we can simply skip. Similarly, when we are interested in trying to find a matching candidate for CD, do we need to iterate over all the words that exist? No. What we are interested in, only those characters that have C in it, which would be only 2. So we have reduced the time complexity from all the possible four words to actually checking only two words, one ACCAA and one AEDCC. This is how we can further reduce the time complexity and improvise the algorithm. without much ado, now let's collate everything that I talked about and let's move on to the coding section. Let's try and understand this code logic. It's not very complicated, but it's lengthy in nature. The first thing that I've done here is to define a map of integer, comma list of integers. So what does this signify? The first key signifies the character position. For A would be 0, B would be 1, C would be 2, and so on. English characters that we have. And list of integers signify the bit mass corresponding to each word that exists. So you'll understand it as we progress ahead. We iterated over all the 26 characters that we have, and we added new bucket entries into it. This signifies the character, and this here we have initialized a new array list. Now let's proceed ahead and generate the bit mask for each word. So consider this as a black box. I'll talk about it in the later section. But what this method is giving us, it's giving the bit mask for each word that we are passing it as a parameter. And this is a temporary string where we have stored it. I iterated over each bit that was set in this temporary bit mask value. So I iterated over 26 times. And again, I checked what all bits were set at each index. And I extracted those entries, those bucket entries from the bucket map and added this new entry that corresponds to the word. So here we have generated or added new entries corresponding to each word against each bucket. So we have built in what I talked about over here, the improvement part. And instead of taking characters, I have taken integer values. And here, instead of taking absolute strings, I have taken the bit mask values of these words. Now let's proceed ahead. And here I have created a result array that actually stores the result. Let's iterate over all the puzzles that we have. Let's generate the bit mask against the first puzzle that we get, and let's call it puzzle mask. Let's extract the first character that exists in this puzzle, in this input puzzle string, and let's call it C. Let's create the count for how many words which actually are valid as per the puzzle P. Let's iterate over all the entries that exist in the bucket corresponding to the character C, which is the first character of the puzzle string, searching for those words that have the first puzzle character in it. And then we check whether word mask and puzzle mask, the AND operation between these two things, gives us the same result as the word mask. If it does, then we increment the count variable. And once we iterate over all the entries that exist in the bucket map, I add it to the result. In the end, I simply return the result. We have iterated over all the puzzle strings that we had. Now comes the question, how are we generating the bit mask? So bit mask generation is also pretty simple and straightforward. I created a new integer value mask, and I iterated over all the characters that exist in the input string. I performed an OR operation, mask equals to mask OR get bit mask at the Cth character. And let's talk about this helper method. It extracts the bit that was set and performs the shift operation. Whatever value is returned from it, it gets ORed with this mask. Let's try and submit this up. Accepted. The time complexity is still not that great. There could be other possible solutions as well to this solution. But this is what I could think of. And a lot of help was provided in the hints for coming up with this approach, the bit masking technique, so I exploited that. This brings me to the end of today's session. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for viewing it. Have a great day ahead and stay tuned for more updates from Coding Decoded. I'll see you tomorrow with another fresh question, but till then, goodbye.